Hello children, you are studying the chapter 8, Water. In the continuation of this chapter, today you will study the types of solution on the basis of the solubility of the solutes. Previously, I taught you the dependence of solubility on temperature and pressure, means how the pressure and temperature affect the solubility of the solute in the liquid. If the solute is solid, then on increasing the temperature, solubility increases. If solute is gas, then on increasing the temperature, the solubility decreases. In case of solid solute, pressure doesn't affect the solubility. But in case of gaseous solute, as we increase the pressure, solubility increases. As we decrease the pressure, solubility decreases. Now next is, depending upon the solubility, the solution may be saturated, unsaturated, or supersaturated. When we take a glass of water, if we dissolve 1 spoon of sugar in it, you stir it, it easily dissolves in water. And if you add more sugar, means more half spoon of sugar in this solution, then half spoon sugar also dissolves in it. It means in this process, when we add more sugar in the solution, or solution is capable of dissolving more solute in it, that type of solution is known as unsaturated solution. Means the solution in which we can dissolve more solute, this solution is known as unsaturated solution. And at that time, temperature remains constant. Means at a constant temperature, if we can dissolve more solute in a given solvent, it means our solution is unsaturated. But for a given temperature, if we are unable to dissolve more solute in it, then the solution is known as saturated solution. Sometimes, solution at a given temperature hold more solute than in normal condition it can hold or it can dissolve. That type of solution is known as supersaturated solution. So, on the basis of solubility, we can divide the solution in 3 types: unsaturated, saturated, and supersaturated. Unsaturated means if amount of solute is very less, we can dissolve more solute in that. That solution is known as unsaturated. If we are unable to dissolve more solute in the solution at a given particular temperature, then the solution is known as saturated solution. If the solution hold more solute that at a normal temperature it can hold, then the solution is known as supersaturated solution. Now next, mixture that you are studying are of 3 types: solution, next is colloids, and last is suspension. solution, colloids and suspension. Solution is the homogeneous mixture is known as solution. Colloids are heterogeneous but has two parts, solute and solvent. Suspension is the heterogeneous mixture in which we can mix the solute, but the solutes are larger in size compared to the solvent molecule. That's why they do not dissolve but suspended throughout the solution. As when we dissolve the, for example, the dust in air, oil shaken in water, or powdered chalk in water, mud in water, these are the suspension solution, suspension mixture in which the liquid holds the larger solute molecule which are not dissolved in that particular solvent. And these are known as, this type of mixture is known as suspension, which is the heterogeneous mixture. We are able to see the solute particle in the solvent. When we left the suspension for some time, all the solute particles settle down at the bottom or as a sediment. And this process is known as sedimentation. So what is the sedimentation? Sedimentation is the process of deposition of suspended particle at the bottom of the suspension mixture. Now, next type of mixture is colloids. Colloids is also a heterogeneous mixture, but it looks like homogeneous because here the particle, solute particle size is comparatively more than the solution, more than the solute particle in solution, and less than the solute particle in suspension. Means the size of the solute particle is intermediate between the solute particle present in solution or and in suspension. These are known as colloidal solution. So we can say it can be homogeneous or heterogeneous, like milk, like our blood. But we cannot distinguish the solute particle here, or we cannot easily separate the solute particle from the colloidal solution. The colloidal particles can pass through the filter paper and they can scatter the light also. So on this basis we can divide the mixture so in three categories: solution, colloids and suspension. Now next topic is given, water of crystallization.